Here with lovely and talented Dean Vitale, Roman Echo. He's going to show me Pegasus self-propulsion, tank-mounted self-propulsion device. And we're going to be working today with several members. And is Fraser the director?
Yeah, he's the director of training for the IAHD.
Which is the International Association of Handicapped Divers. Two of the divers we're working with today are going to be are paraplegic, and then we have one diver who's a quadriplegic diver. This device simply just mounts on the tank, and when you put it together, you put the bracket on first.
Yep, and then you just okay. Snap everything else on. You just center it up once you get this fed under.
Mm-hmm. Is it actually, I mean, what's the easiest way of assembling it? Out of the water, in the water, I mean, any preference?
For the disabled divers in the water, it swaps over easy because they'll go on their back and you can change it from tank to tank. With a 80 cubic inch tank, it stands up, you build your BC up, you lay it over, you put it all on, you snap it in, because the motor comes to the tank right about here, as you've seen in some of the pictures, and you can just stand the whole unit up. So for a non-disabled diver, it's probably easier to do out of the water.
Okay.
It's not going to be too much.
Now, the device itself weighs 10 pounds.
Yeah, it's just shy of 10 pounds. Mm-hmm. And in the water, it's negative 5-pound buoyancy.
I can't get over the simplicity. It's
just a couple extra 2-pounders because we're in salt water.
Okay. And then we'll use this real quick. Just get a quick check. So you can see it draw on the water. And what we've done yesterday, too, from Sharon's suggestion, is normally on the a diver with no disabilities, we can kick the motor like this because of CG.
Right.
But with the being the CG of the disabled divers is different, we've actually cantered it this way. So it provides more propulsion even with the tank.
Right.
And it helps them out. It works a lot better. Should be anyway. I'm
going to jump in.
Okay,
I got the legs, come on down in here, we're doing fine. Fine. Okay, I've got Winky.
You guys get the
PC. I got.
You're
gonna put the left arm in?
Yeah.
What did you decide to do yesterday? The left arm in, take the right one, we're gonna put it around.
Okay.
Now the unit is already on here.
Good.
It's going to take us about 6 hours to get them out of the bloody water now. It's one of the major problems when we're working with these guys is once you get them in the water, you can never get them out because they use the emotional tie on you.
Oh.
You
teach us.
You're going to do this on your left hand or your right hand?
Control.
He needs to go under his arm.
Feel it?
Oh, sure.
Thank you. Thank you.